Truth be told, I don't think she knows. I don't think she knows what she had. Not the summer, almost all of the time. Cause I don't want her back.
Critics aren't so bad.
I have no modesty left after X-Men. Well, they didn't give me my safety deposit back because the bathtub was blue. But it's their fault for not having a shower. Who only has a bath without a shower? I also did it to a lot of toilet seats all around set. We called it getting mistinked when your toilet seat was blue.
I was reading trashy magazines. I was on an airplane. It's my one guilty pleasure. And I'm flipping through, and I find a picture of me in a bathing suit.
May I show this picture or not?
And it's not my butt. And I will not take responsibility for it. It's a 90-year-old butt that's been photoshopped onto my body and is posing as my butt.
May I show this?
Yes.
This is not your anatomy.
This is not my butt.
You have proof. You have something by which we could compare.
Well, no. Yeah. I'm sure somewhere.
No, but it started to do this terrible thing where somebody will ask a question and I'll just automatically go to answer it, and then somebody will be like, they're talking to me. And I'm like, oh God, I'm turning into one of those people.
So have you started getting sketches for beautiful gowns already?
I have, but...
Do you have anything picked out?
Yeah, I do, but I don't know, I'm not a fashion person, so I look at the sketch and I'm like, I don't know what, it's like looking at a math problem. I'm like, oh yeah.
Congratulations on your film, guys. Honestly, I really did very much enjoy it. This is the most...
I love when someone says, like, honestly, I did, because right away I go, no, I didn't.
No, why do you say
honestly,
that?
Honestly, I did, because nobody believed me, because they thought it was awful.
No, but you know for the future now, when I don't say honestly in the sentence, and I say I really liked your movie, I am lying then.
Okay.
So honestly, I did like the movie.
Okay. I'm confused.
Yeah, don't worry.
Just move on.
It's okay.
Don't worry about me.
Now, you look lovely. What are you wearing?
Thank you. I'm wearing Valentino Couture, Liz. Hey, Liz. Valentino Couture?
Yes.
Sorry. I'm wearing Valentino Couture. And I
love
know
it.
So much about it.
No.
This is not my first terrible picture. I'm very unphotogenic. Like, I'm totally open with, there are just really bad moments that, like, now this is bloat.
There's nothing wrong
now
with
that. Look at
crazy.
That.
Crazy. There's nothing wrong with that.
No, my makeup artist who's been doing my makeup for years
fine.
Didn't believe that that was me.
No,
and
you look
she goes, now that's what I call bloated.
Okay, chemistry looks pretty good off camera too. What do you have to say about that?
It's hit and miss, to be honest. It has its ups and downs, its highs and lows.
It depends if we're in front of a camera or not.
Yeah, exactly. Depends on that time of the month for me or not. That really determines a lot.
That time of the month?
For me.
Yeah, just its period.
I really miss.
You're not on the same.
Hi. Then a director pulls me into his office and is like, I want you to, you know, gain some weight. And I was like, no problem. I'll get right on that. And then at the end of the movie, he goes, you're going to be wearing tight spandex pants and a belly shirt, which is normally the exact opposite order of things. Gain weight, you're going to wear a belly shirt. So that was awesome.
I mean, this guy is a great dancer.
Is he really?
Yeah, I'm like a dad at a prom.
That's what I read. Yeah. What is a dad at a prom, but what does that mean? I don't believe that's how you dance at all, but I love that.
You want to go out tonight? You want to see it? Okay. Okay. But show the 90-year-old mm-hmm. that. Just everyone,
I don't know if
feast
we can
your
show
eyes
this.
On this. Look at that. Look at that.
That's not you.
No. And my face looks like I know what they're doing. My face almost looks like that's not my butt,
yeah.
Even in the photo.
Do you know where this was taken? Do you remember?
In Hawaii, when I was surfing with my brother. And...
Whoa, do you surf, really?
Yeah, well, I mean, not well, but yeah.
But
yeah,
that's pretty cool.
Okay, kid put from it down King now. God. Want me to make
kid,
it a t-shirt of it?
Kid from... So that's not your butt. We'll take
no,
your
No,
that's
not my butt, and that's the most important thing that I want everyone to take away this evening.
I live in a kind of a perpetual state of nerves, so I can't really tell if it was on the day of the dance or when I found out I had to dance or practicing for the dance when it was clear that I am a terrible dancer. Horrible. Like, I look like Gumby got electrocuted. I have no control over my limbs. I walk like a baby deer and dance like one. So I think that there was never really one moment where it hit me that I was nervous about that. That was just kind of a constant feeling.
And she rehearsed and killed it.
No,
I rehearsed as much as I possibly could and still sucked ass.
That's not true. Well, we were supposed to suck.
Dancer right. ever. No, I was supposed to suck after I already danced and sucked.
We put that ADR line where
exactly.
you're like, I'm not good.
I'm like, I'm not a good dancer.
That's so great. We should probably put that in this.
In the script. That's what we did after.
I know.
And pose.
It helps everything. Helps everybody's
yeah,
performance.
It just kind of so explains funny. Why I move my body like a baby colt.
No.
Is it weird to have an audience love you so much? Has it gotten strange?
Yeah, I know. I was never sitting in the theater going, God, this audience loves me so much. That's so weird. Hi, oh my God, I'm sweating so much. I'm going to drop it. Oh God, Robert Downey Jr. knows. I sweat all over you when I shook his hand. Anyway, sorry, focus.
My parents spent the night because I have sleepovers with my parents because, you know, I'm cool.
What's the scene you're in an argument with Robert De Niro?
Yes, he thinks that I have messed with the Eagles' juju, so I've come to set him straight.
Mm-hmm. All right. And this is contemporary, or is it like 20 years ago, or
God,
contemporary?
Don't worry about it. Just play the clip, and you'll find out.
Come on, baby, light my fire. I was losing in tennis, and I was throwing like a total tantrum, and someone drove by playing that song, and now every time I hear that song, I want to throw a tennis racket.
Is Francis the right guy to take over for Gary here? Are you happy with the switch?
Yeah, he's great. Oh, very, very. I'll take both.
Don't do it, Bradley.
I don't know. I'm not going to react.
The arm's folded. She's above it.
I'm above it.
Okay, so what?
3 days. Good evening, training. Yeah. So, oh my God, this has this pocket. Sorry.
I've never really researched a movie. A terrible thing to say. I don't mean to.
Well, everybody does it differently. It's not.
Yeah,
like
I. That's my excuse. I'm like when it's late at night and I'm like eating a bag of potato chips and I have to work the next day and the script's all the way over there and I don't want to pick it up. I'm like, what's my process? I can't show up to work prepared tomorrow. That's not how I work.
Yeah, I was just like a pathological liar when I was a kid. I was just always lied about everything. And I think it was like partly I just wanted to one-up somebody. Like mm-hmm. somebody would be like, oh God, my leg hurts. And I'd be like, your legs hurt. I'm getting mine amputated next week. And that's actually how my mother found out. She came to school and somebody was like, God, that's such a shame about Jennifer's legs.
Yeah.
And so she made me purge and I had to wrap myself up in a blanket and go underneath my bed and I had to spill out all of my lies. And I was really? Like, I said that Dad drove a barge and we were millionaires and you were pregnant and I had to get my legs amputated and I spayed cats and dogs on the weekends. Like,
Jennifer,
I'm gonna calm down.
You just met Taylor Swift, it's all right.
I just met Taylor Swift and I'm still freaking out, sorry.
You have totally changed since an hour ago.
I know. He needs to answer the questions because I'm still geeking out. So you take it.
Well, I was wrong for the part. I was way too young. But I guess we turned that around. Fixed it in post.
Any injuries?
Well, lots, but they're all stupid. None of them are like cool. Like one time I like hit myself in the chin with my bow.
Ow, but that hurts.
Cool. Yeah.
What are you going to do to celebrate?
I'm going to take some NyQuil and some Tamiflu and get in bed.
Because you're not feeling what you have the flu?
Yeah.
You would never know it, though. I got to be honest.
I've got piles of makeup on. So
that's what
you.
It is.
I couldn't stop squeezing David. I felt like a stage mother. I was like, listen, they love you.
What does this tell us about you? Are you insecure as a child? That you needed to one-up everybody?
I think that I just love stories, Dave. I don't mm-hmm. think I was insecure. I was in third grade.
How would you describe yourself now?
And very well-rounded and practically perfect.
No, you can see my legs, so I'm totally...
I know, right?
I'm like in a circus tent right now.
I said yes to the movie before I actually read the script. I'm a huge David O. Russell fan. Do I need to do this?
Not that close. I like this kind of thing. You know what to do. Maybe a little higher.
Yeah. I'm confused because we're outside.
I'm sorry to throw this curveball in your life.
You really threw me off.
Coming up, we're still in Katniss mode right now.
Yes,
right?
Still in Katniss.
Is it hard to remove yourself from that character?
No. I'm not really method at all. As soon as they call cut, I'm like thinking about food and moving on.
It's the like really artistic questions that just totally throw me through a loop. And they're like, what do you hope audiences take away from like the characters of so much? And I don't even understand what they're saying, but I can't go, what? I'm just like, oh, I think. And I just like have to talk around in circles and circles. And I'm like staring at my publicist like, am I doing okay? Am I making sense?
And does she always say yes? Or is she something?
No, she never says yes.
You got a little excited about Christina Aguilera. You geeked out a little
Well,
bit.
Okay, yeah, because
but
that's
it's Christina
we grew
Aguilera.
Up like
no,
listening
I get
to Christina
it. Yeah,
Aguilera.
No, no. Yeah. You should have seen Josh and I when they say Christina Aguilera.
We literally both go, what?
Harvey, you are a little rascal. but none of this would be possible without you. You've opened doors for me. Some doors that I didn't even want opened, but you did it.
And you're making a lot of money. You are, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, good.
Hi, I'm Jennifer Lawrence, and I'm hosting SNL with the Lumineers.
Ooh, all right, Hunger Games, let's see what you got. Go for it.
Jason, I told you, it's just a movie.
It's gonna be fun either way, okay? Here we go.
This is a terrible idea.
Oh, my God.
We gotta get out of here.
We need to get out of here.
We gotta get out of here, man.
There's four of us. This way.
What?
I just saw it.
You just saw what?
Hunger Games.
You did?
I didn't text you.
Yeah, you texted me.
Yeah, hello.
Yeah,
we're actually having a real conversation.
This
isn't
real.
No. Yeah, thank you.
Yeah, I'm actually talking to you.
Yeah.
Like a human being.
Yeah.
I'm not
used to it.
So what's the worst question you've gotten this year?
Probably, what grand lady would you like to play in the past? Because I said Bridget Jones. And the worst part was, I didn't even think about it. Like, it just, like, came right out, which means that's really how I feel. Like, that was my first instinct. Like, a grand old lady, Bridget Jones.
Well, thank you so much.
All right,
have a good
you.
Night. Thanks, Jennifer. Oh, don't forget your award.
Oh, right. Sorry.